He was written into the Big Lebowski without his knowledge, and he's officially in the Mustache Hall of Fame. Keep watching for so much more about the untold truth of Sam Elliott. Born in 1944 in Sacramento, California, Sam Elliott began acting in the late 60s. He did what a lot of actors before him had done. He started out in small roles in television westerns, eventually earning slightly more substantial parts in the hit shows Lancer and Mission Impossible. His first role in a major film came in 1969's Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid, which featured the superstar leads Paul Newman and Robert Redford in the title roles. A comedic western based on the lives of two notorious bank-robbing outlaws, the film seems like a perfect fit for Elliott, who spent much of his career working within the genre. Unfortunately for him, he had a blink-and-you'll-miss-it part as a card player. He didn't even have any lines. While the role didn't have much of an impact on his career, the movie did have a rather coincidental place in his life. Starring beside Newman and Redford was Catherine Ross, and though she and Elliott shared no scenes and didn't cross paths during filming, nearly 10 years later they did meet again and started dating as co-leads in The Legacy. It wasn't long before the couple were married. Today they're still together and they have a daughter. Over the course of the 1970s and 1980s, Sam Elliott never quite hit it big, but he did enjoy increasing recognition as a character actor appearing in television shows, TV movies, and big screen productions. His first major starring role in a feature film came in 1976's Lifeguard, which tells the tale of a lifeguard working in Southern California who's forced into self-reflection after attending a high school reunion and realizing that his classmates have accomplished greater things with their lives. While the movie performed decently in the box office, Elliott publicly complained about the film's marketing during the promotional tour, which caused the studio heads at Paramount to become displeased. As a result, he never worked with the company again. That wasn't the only trouble he experienced during this period. During an interview in 1980, Elliott revealed that he had been propositioned repeatedly during auditions, saying, "You cannot believe the casting couch stories I could tell you, man. The cliches are all true. I've had propositions from men and women, and I've turned them all down. It's probably hurt me, but I'm the one who has to live with that guilt. My conscience is clear, even though my career is still not setting the world on fire." Perhaps unsurprisingly, he later became a vocal supporter of the Me Too movement. However, these decades weren't all hard times, as he scored a number of high-profile roles. In 1985, he starred in a supporting role alongside Cher in Mask, and in 1989, he starred next to Patrick Swayze in the cult classic Roadhouse. By the time the 1990s rolled around, Sam Elliott had spent more than 20 years in Hollywood, but he still didn't have much in the way of name recognition. For the most part, he seemed destined to forever be a somewhat acknowledged face without a name. With the arrival of his third decade in the business, however, that was about to change. After playing a substantial part in the critically acclaimed Civil War epic Gettysburg, Elliott starred alongside Kurt Russell in the now classic western Tombstone, which was hailed by audiences and critics alike. In the role of Virgil Earp, from the famous real-life Old West family of lawmen headed by the renowned Wyatt Earp, Elliott was particularly captivating. This helped to propel him into prominent parts in future films. Sadly enough, Elliott's father, who never wanted him to become an actor, didn't get a chance to see his success begin. The two sparred over the career choice and were never able to settle their differences, as his father died of a heart attack when Elliott was just 18. Many years later, while speaking in an interview with The Star, Elliott explained, "He died thinking, man, this kid is going to go down the wrong path. And I think on some levels, that was either hard on me or made me more focused in my resolve to have a career, you know what I mean?" These days, The Big Lebowski is almost universally considered one of the Coen brothers' greatest films, and one of its many iconic characters is Elliott's The Stranger, a surreal narrator who delivers some of the movie's most quotable lines.
"Darkness washed over the dude, darker than a black steer's tuchus on a moonless prairie night."
According to an interview in the New York Times, Elliott was initially disappointed at being cast as yet another cowboy. That was until he read the script. Speaking to NPR, Elliott explained that as he looked through the screenplay, he spotted a surprise. As he explained it, "Over the dialogue, there's this tumbling tumbleweed blowing and talk about this Southwest accent and sounding not unlike Sam Elliott. It had my name in the script." Later, as they were filming his final scene, Elliott became exasperated by going through take after take. The Coen brothers finally admitted that they had already gotten what they wanted, but they enjoyed watching and listening to him so much that they had him do it again and again.
"Well, that about does her. Wraps are all up."
Part of what helped propel Sam Elliott to success was his distinctive voice, and over the years, he's lent it to a wide variety of high-profile commercials. Perhaps the most notable products you might have heard his familiar voice hawking are Coors Beer and Dodge Ram heavy-duty trucks. Since 2008, Elliott has also voiced Smokey Bear, the U.S. Forest Service mascot created to help with wildfire prevention efforts. You probably have heard his catchphrase,
"Only you can prevent wildfires."
Another fun fact? Elliot not only delivers Smokey's famous catchphrase, but he actually shares his birth date with the fictional Spokes Bear, August 9, 1944. While Sam Elliott's star has been rising steadily for some 20 years or so, in the 2010s he really took off. By the middle of the decade, he had recurring roles in the Netflix series The Ranch and Grace and Frankie. He also lent his voice to the 2015 animated film The Good Dinosaur. Then in 2017, Elliott starred in The Hero, a film about an aging Western star whose best days are behind him. Not only was it the perfect role for him, but according to the film's writer and director Brett Haley, it was literally written for Elliott. As Haley explained to the LA Times, "To me, it was a love letter not only to Sam, but to a dying breed of actor in film in Hollywood." Shortly after that, Elliott starred in the flat-out bizarre B-film The Man Who Killed Hitler and then The Bigfoot, which fared well with critics thanks largely to Elliott's performance. In 2018, Sam Elliott hit another major high point in his career so far with his performance in A Star Is Born. Directed by Bradley Cooper and starring Cooper, Elliott, and Lady Gaga, the movie is about the relationship between an up-and-coming singer and her alcoholic mentor. A Star Is Born was a massive success by every measure, earning $436 million on a $36 million budget. It garnered almost universal praise from the critics and scored 8 Oscar nominations, including Best Picture, 1 win for Best Original Song, and 1 nomination for Best Supporting Actor for Sam Elliott. Shockingly, this was his first Academy Award nomination, indicating that even at 75 years old, his career still had exciting places to go. Elliott's performance in the film also earned him a nomination for Outstanding Performance by a Male Actor in a Supporting Role at the Screen Actors Guild Awards, and a win for Best Supporting Actor at the National Board of Review Awards. Not bad for an old cowboy. Along with his smooth, deep voice and tough demeanor, Sam Elliott is best recognized by his iconic mustache, and we're not the only ones who think so. In 2015, Elliott was inducted into the Mustache Hall of Fame, alongside the likes of real-life legends such as Teddy Roosevelt, Hulk Hogan, and Billy Dee Williams, as well as fictional characters such as Ned Flanders and Yosemite Sam. Talk about a distinguished class of facial hair. While we all know and love his superior upper lip sweater, Elliott himself doesn't quite understand all the fuss. Sam Elliott might not get all the attention, but we totally do. That's some ferocious facial fuzz he's got there. Of course, these days, Sam Elliott is among the most recognizable faces in the industry, as he continues to shine on screens big and small. His latest breakout hit is 1883 on Paramount Plus, the prequel to the series Yellowstone. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Looper videos about your favorite stars are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.